Ashley, how you doing? Andrea here with Tony. Well, I can't even see. There's Sean and Bill, the doctor man. All right. So we've got your pedestal. I sent you a picture of it going in the box and before that, so you know what it looks like there. But Sean's going to explain to you how to deal with this crate.
Yeah. So when you receive your crate, you're going to need some guys, obviously. It's pretty heavy in there. The whole thing weighs about 700 pounds in the crate, so be careful. And in order to get into this thing, you can pick these little latch levers. If you take them, you twist them like this. And that will release the door. So the little handle here, you grab the handle, pull it up. So inside, we got some foam.
Well, this foam, so you can set one of the pedestals
that's
already in here, set it on.
On the floor.
Okay.
The second piece of foam that Tony's getting now. This is a plate to keep the product level with the floor so you can slide it out nice and easy and pick it up without causing any damage. This is real important that you load and unload the unit this way so that you don't cause damage to anything. So, you ready for it? That's how you do it. You grab it nice and easy. And up on the ball. So that slides real nice. So then, are we going to take it looking down for you?
On this side, allow these spacers to keep the pedestals in place. It's really easy to get them out.
Right. And they go in a certain spot, too.
This one goes up.
And they're notched on the corners.
They notch,
you'll see. So it's important to put them back that way when you receive your merchandise. So then you get the foam out. You come and grab this one out of here. Set it on your full protection floor, just like that, whatever you want. So the other part of this is
just protection in the pedestal. All these come out.
Right.
All this stuff comes out.
All comes out so you guys can fill it full of water. And then, if you look right up here and down there, there are two plates that, like a kind of a cover, that protects the edges of this for you. You pop this off and put it back on every time you ship it, okay? Because this is gonna save a lot of damage. So just take this thing off and you flip it down. We can do that for you. Should we do that or? It just pops right off.
Yeah.
So you flip it down and it'll pop right off, but be sure you put it back on. The orange on the top and the short one on the bottom. And that gives it protection. That'll really help on the corners keep them clean.
Take that one out.
This is what the container looks like on the inside.
If
you want to check it out real quick. So what we got here is we got the protection foam. We got a little bit of yellow skid plate here. I mean, a white skid plate, sort of slide real easy. And then we went and added this little bit of extra room for your products or something you don't want to stuff in there, some posters or something. We had to make it 40 inches wide due to the fact that of the height and the balance of it all, we don't want to flip it over in the trucks. So that's why there's that space in there. So, okay. So we're going to put this back in now, right?
We should take those plates.
Let's take the plates
off.
Huh? Let's flip it down and we'll show them. You want to flip it this way, Ben?
Well, you're getting the whole tour here.
We're going to flip this down, take the top and bottom off so you get the idea.
Watch the doggy. Got a little dog over here. Set it aside.
Set it down.
Throw it back in the crate.
Okay. Lift that side up.
And then we'll put some labels on this so you'll know this is the bottom, the shorter one on the bottom, taller one on the top. And we'll label that for you guys so it'll be easy. Okay? So now we're going to put it back in the box. So after the show, big event weekend, grab the bottom plate first. guys. Lift it up. Secure the bottom plate. Like that. Okay. Try to use the foam as much as possible for protection when moving them around. So we're just going to flip that up. Tony's going to go ahead and back on. Put the top back on. We're just going to move it closer to the container.
You can just move all that stuff in first.
Oh, yeah. Yes, we have the foam. The scrap foam, the protection foam we have to put in first. So. There you go, Tony. Goes in one direction, so you know, try to remember which way it came out, it'll be a lot easier. Put it like that, so that's nice and secure. All right, yeah, you notice it's got a notch on that corner, so that corner goes to that corner. You'll see
it's on the back foam, yeah. There, Tony. Yeah,
see this right here? There's a notch on that foam, and that's gonna go to this corner here. Okay, so. Sorry. It was right here, just needed to be flipped the other way, that's all. You got it, buddy. Nope, one more time.
Skinny side, you
know.
You should number them or something.
So just kind of give it a little bit of shake, shimmy like that, so that it all just fall in position really easy for you. And there you go, there it is. Nice and packed up. For multi-use trade shows. I need it. It's got one guy, nice and easy, gently.
Maybe
pushes
just
it
right
in.
On this front bottom, front top, you know.
He's got it.
Got it?
Yep. Yep. Make sure everything lines up, you know. If you start to push it in and it doesn't want to go in, that means something's not lined up right, so just take another second and kind of look around it and line it up. It'll shove right in nice and sweet once it's all in position. So, and now we're going to close the door. And what we did is we're going to put hinges on here for you guys to make it nice and easy and you don't lose your door if you want to ship it home or wherever back it goes to. It's some nice easy locks. So what we recommend you guys do is get some of these like little zip ties. And we're going to do this is we just go ahead and zip tie this right through the handle like that. And what that'll do is that'll lock this thing in position so that it doesn't swim open in transit. Like that. Just lock the hand down to the little collar knuckle, whatever you want to call it.
Just with
the
zip tie?
Just with the zip tie. Because what happens is sometimes these are nice. They're pretty tight. So they may not, but when they're in trucks, they get rubbed against stuff. And this might. It might spring open and it might possibly go like this, but when you go ahead and secure it with a zip tie like this, you're securing that down.
I guess can't not. Pop open.
Wait a minute. It just did that. It popped open.
Right?
Well, you just tighten it down. Yeah. The zip tie wasn't tight. If you tighten the zip tie down, it'll hold it in position for you, and then it'd be good. Or you could just tape it. Some people tape it, but we don't have a lot of problems with it. These hinges, these works really nice. Ratchet. There it is.
Thanks,
you
guys.
Hope you enjoy your container, and good luck.
Thank you for your business.
Thank you.
Wow, that's a lot of information. So you're going to have to take that video and give it to your shop guys or, you know, whoever's going to warehouse this thing. Thanks a lot, Ashley. Hope it works out great for you. Bye now.